It is December 1st. We are almost to Christmas. 25 days until Christmas as of the making of this video. It's going to be a fun month on the channel. Today, we're going to be looking at a ton of Fortnite stuff, guys. We're going to be over on Reddit looking at stuff. We're going to talk about Fortnite being recorded on a VCR. We're going to be talking about the lights coming on in the secret castle. All kinds of stuff. We're also going to be talking about, is Fortnite trying to trick parents into buying their freeze bundle, their deep freeze bundle? We're gonna talk about that as well. But before we get into everything, guys, it is December 1st. Every year, I do a chaos Christmas holiday giveaway, whatever you wanna call it, and it is time, guys. Check it out on the screen right now. This is the chaos holiday giveaway, and 10 lucky winners are going to get to pick their present. You are either going to get Battlefield 5, Black Ops 4, Fallout 76, or Red Dead Redemption 2 on the platform of your choice. Link is at the top of the description. There are multiple ways to enter this, guys. Plus, there's a bonus tweet over on my Twitter, which is in the description as well. You guys know how I do this. This is one way for me to give back to you guys. Over on Twitter, I am also doing a giveaway every day until Christmas. I am giving away more this month than I have any other December holiday month on the channel or for Team Chaos. So definitely get in on these giveaways, guys. Good luck. 10 people are gonna win the game of their choice, and you're gonna win it before Christmas. That way I can get it to you so you have it for the holidays or for the Christmas break so you can go and play and enjoy. Now, let's get into some stuff that, there's a lot of stuff we're gonna talk about. We're gonna start over on Fortnite Intel. We're gonna talk about a Fortnite fan making a Frost Raider concept skin. Now you guys know the Renegade Raider is one of the rarest skins in Fortnite, and this guy, he made a Frost Raider concept that Epic should go pay him, cut him a check, and say, let us license this design because it is absolutely amazing. So let's go down and check it out. Fortnite fans are a creative bunch. Season 7 is fast approaching. Next week, guys, we're gonna be covering all that stuff. And these clues combined with Winter Royale, blah, 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 blah. Check it out. Check it out. Here we go. Reddit user VP underscore SPX showcased their skills by posting a winter theme titled Frost Raider. The skin repurposes the Renegade Raider with winter themed colored white, gray, light blue to match the landscape. Slung across her back is an icy pickaxe covered in barbed wire. You guys see this on the screen? That, it would probably be the fastest selling skin in shop history if they actually put this in. So I'm gonna petition now. Epic, make this a real thing for the holiday event sometime this month. Make this skin real, and I promise you, people are going to buy this one up. Now, I wanted to give you guys a quick update about the rapper 2 Milli. We talked about how he was talking about suing Fortnite for taking his dance, and you guys can see it on the screen here. He said he wanted to protect what was his. I talked about this with some friends. Can you actually copyright dance moves? And apparently, he's going after it, guys. 2 Milli claims his dance move was used in Fortnite without his permission. He hired Pierce Bainbridge, David L. Heck to pursue claims against Fortnite and Epic Games. New York, Brooklyn rapper 2 Milli is engaged with these people to pursue claims over its misappropriation, use, and sale of 2 Milli's signature Milli Rock as downloadable content in its popular game. This is gonna be interesting to see how this plays out, because if he actually wins this case and gets royalties or compensation from Epic, you're gonna see a lot of other people that Epic has kind of taken their emotes, dances, things like that, and they're gonna try to sue them. And when you're as big as Epic and you're pulling in 100 million, 200 million a month, whatever it may be, you are a huge target. So I'm gonna follow this, guys, and I will let you know what actually happens with this. How many of these emotes do you think were sold in Fortnite? How much money do you think Epic made off 2 Milli's dance? You guys, let me know. Now, let's move over to Reddit for a minute. I wanna show you guys a couple posts. I wanna show you somebody's concept for an offline mode. This VCR VHS tape where you can actually play Fortnite. Then we're gonna talk about how Fortnite may be, they may be doing a little tricky, I guess you could say tricky marketing for parents to buy something that's not exactly what it is. You guys will understand what I'm talking about when we get over to it, but we're on Reddit right now, and this is pretty cool. This is, it's Fortnite on a VCR, and I'm just gonna play it. I'm not gonna have any volume, but I want you guys to see it. That is, if you don't know what a VCR is or a VHS, that's what people used to watch movies on, and check it out. You've got the old school TV, and he is actually going to put on Fortnite from his VCR on a VHS tape. If you don't know what a VHS tape is, go look it up and you'll understand why this is actually pretty cool. It really is. And he's playing Fortnite on this. Look at that. Look at that hi-fi. Look at that hi-fi. That SLP. Look at those quality graphics, my friends. That's pretty cool. 4x3 maybe? I don't know, but I thought that was pretty cool and I wanted to share it with you. We're just going to scroll through Reddit because there's a couple things I wanted to show you guys. Who turned the lights on the castle? Now, I said yesterday, I fully believe there's something in the castle that is on the iceberg that is heading towards the map. I really, really do. I think it's either a bad guy or a good guy. AIM may be a scout robot, and he's working for somebody that's in this castle. We'll have to wait and see, but every season, Fortnite Epic Games have a good team, and they have a bad team. So I think it's a pretty good guess to guess that something is housed in that castle that's either really bad or really good. Now, let's talk about a cool concept from John Burpo over on Reddit, the game mode idea offline. And a lot of people have asked for this for a long, long time. They want, kind of like in Call of Duty, you want that offline where you can just warm up against bots and you can set their level to whatever you want it to be. And people have wanted this, and he put the concept together. Offline solo simulates a normal solo game. Maximum of 99 bots unless you are 1-2. Haha. Various bot difficulties, easy and medium and hard. And this would be really, really cool. A lot of people would enjoy this just for practice, being able to kind of scrim themselves against bots to warm up, get their aim going, whatever reason. But here's the problem. How are you going to make the AI to where they simulate how somebody would build when they get rushed up on in Fortnite, or how somebody would tactically build in the last circle of a game? I don't know. I mean, obviously I'm not a developer. I don't know the coding of AI in video games, but I would think that would be a little bit difficult and a little hard to crack to get the bots to react kind of like a human would. But then again, it is an offline mode and you have to have expectations that are set for bots as well. Or I mean, they could just be 99 bots running around, but I mean, you would want them to be able to build and kind of mimic what a human would do in that mode. So I think it's a great idea. I just don't know if they can make the AI do what they want to simulate that type of mode, because solo battle royale in Fortnite, well, it just any mode for Fortnite, it's very unique. I mean, no mode is the same at all. I mean, no game is the same. So I don't know. I think it's a cool idea though, and I hope something comes from it. There's one more thing I wanted to show on here. Let's see if I can find it here. Where's it at? Come on. Oh man, please. The only thing I'm interested in seeing on the top of the freaking iceberg. That is right. Bring it back, please. I think that was it. Okay, you guys can see it on the screen here, and I posted on my YouTube and Instagram stories yesterday. The Fortnite Battle Bus is at Walmart, okay? You can get shirts, you can get the action figures. I think who was in there? The Cuddle Team Leader was in there, I think, and maybe one or two more. But this is kind of weird, and my friend Minnesota Bird showed me this on Reddit yesterday. Okay, first look at this, right? First look at this. What is the first thing you think? You think, that's a video game. That looks exactly like a PlayStation 4 game. It's marked $44.95. That's got to be a game. That has to be Fortnite the game, right? Well, it's not. You can see that is a voucher code for the Fortnite Deep Freeze bundle. Now, I don't know who posted this. I don't know if this is out at every Walmart, but he is definitely at Walmart in Santa's Picks. And this definitely is some tricky marketing, because if you're a parent and you're looking, you're saying, oh, my kid wants Fortnite the game, right? Look, there it is, PlayStation 4, Fortnite. Obviously, there's a Fortnite character on it. It's $44.95, right? Well, I'm gonna get it for him, but it's not the game. It's not the game at all. You can see at the bottom, internet connection required includes PSN voucher code for Fortnite Battle Royale and Deep Freeze bundle, which tells you you're getting Fortnite Battle Royale, right? So the parent's like, I'm getting the game, but you're paying $44.95 to get a free game, and then you're going to get your Deep Freeze bundle, which I could have swore that thing was like $29.99. I don't remember exactly, but it wasn't $44.95. So a parent goes and picks this up. They're like, oh, Fortnite the game. Yay, this is what my kid wants for Christmas, and they're paying $44, but the game is free. Your kid can go download the game for free right now. So in all essence, you're paying $44.95 for the Deep Freeze bundle. This is packaged like it's a brand new PlayStation 4 game, when in fact, it's not exactly that. So it's tricky. I want to know what you guys think. Then again, this could be a retailer that marked this up themselves and it was $29.95 and they put their own sticker on it. So just beware. If you're a parent for some reason watching this video, just make sure you know what you're buying, because if you buy this, you're technically getting the Deep Freeze bundle, you're getting a couple skins, you're getting some V-Bucks, right? But you're getting the game, but the game's already free. So just keep that in mind. And I don't know, I just thought that was kind of weird, because it's packaged just like a brand new game, but it's a free game. So you're really focused on the bundle. You guys, let me know what you think about that. Like I said, it is December. It's gonna be a fun time. You guys, enter that giveaway before or below the Chaos Holiday giveaway. 10 winners are going to get to pick their game. You're gonna get to unwrap your digital box and pick one of the four most popular titles this fall, winter, whatever you want to call it. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll be back tonight with a gaming top 10 as well, and I'll see you soon.